Arrival is another movie directed by Denis Villeneuve. Denis Villeneuve is one of my favorite directors working today. I loved his past work like Prisoners and Sicario last year, which was one of my top five favorite movies of 2015. This movie stars Amy Adams, Jeremy Renner, Forrest Whitaker. It's a story about an alien invasion. Aliens have come down to Earth and they're in these giant spaceship pod things. They look like giant Godzilla eggs, so I'm just gonna call them Zillas for the purposes of this review. There are 12 Zillas scattered around the Earth in different parts of the globe. There's one in the United States. Amy Adams plays a world-renowned linguist and language expert, and she gets recruited by the military along with Jeremy Renner to try to figure out why these aliens are here and to try to figure out, you know, who, what, when, where, why. They want to figure out why they're there, what do they want, how did they get there, all the, you know, the whole shebang. As they're doing this, tension is very high throughout the rest of the world. The rest of the world is kind of on edge, waiting to see what's gonna happen with these aliens. First Hacksaw Ridge last week, and now Arrival this week. Two classics in 2 weeks. This is boding extremely well for the end of the year. Just saying. I'm a huge sci-fi fan. I love sci-fi as a genre. My favorite type of sci-fi is the sci-fi that makes you think, you know, the thought-provoking type of sci-fi. Sci-fi that asks big questions and gives you big answers, or lets you figure out some of these answers for yourself. This is exactly the type of sci-fi that Denis Villeneuve has directed, because this is a beautifully directed, beautifully shot, well-acted masterpiece of a movie. I loved this movie so much. This movie asks big questions about knowledge and about language and about the power of words. It asks a lot of big questions about past and present and future and fate. It also asks big questions about humanity and what we do in times of stress. It's about unity and fear, and all of these heady themes are just handled and executed to perfection in this movie. Visually, this movie is gorgeous. Fucking beautiful. It just looks amazing. I called Dr. Strange visual porn when I reviewed it last week. This isn't visual porn as much as it's visual love making. Dr. Strange is visual porn because it's really hardcore sex with your eyes, and it's really awesome, and there's just a whole bunch of really awesome shit flying on screen. The movie isn't visual porn. It pretty much just lays you down missionary style. Play some Isaac Hayes music and it gives you some sweet love making with your eyes. There's one great shot where they get to the base of operations for this Zilla in Montana. Oh my God, it is such a breathtaking shot. It is such a beautiful shot. My eyes watered just from looking at it. For one crazy moment, I thought that Roger Deakins was the one who did the cinematography. He's a guy that's worked with Denis Villeneuve before. No, the cinematography was done by a guy named Bradford Young. Bradford Young, I can't even give you the slow clap. I'm reduced to giving you the neck clap in order to show you my respect and appreciation for you. Thanks, buddy. You did awesome. The performance is amazing. Amy Adams definitely deserves some type of Oscar for her performance in this movie. She was brilliant. She was commanding. She captured every single scene. She was captivating. She made you want to watch her. Her performance is so subtle and so nuanced and so multi-layered. You just really care and connect to this character. She doesn't have one of those big emotional Oscar bait scenes where she's just kind of over-exaggerating things just to sell the fact that she needs an Oscar. But her performance is so subdued and restrained and held back, she deserves one anyway just for being able to pull that shit off. Forrest Whitaker is great. Jeremy Renner is also really good in this movie. He's a scientist. He's kind of the sidekick and the tag-along character for Amy Adams. But in a movie like this, you need a character like that. You need a character that the main hero can connect to, a character that the main hero can develop a relationship with, because otherwise she's on an island. And we don't like our heroes to be on an island. You know, unless they're Tom Hanks and Castaway, we don't like our heroes to be left on an island. This movie is thought-provoking, it's intelligent, it's deep, it's powerful, it's emotional. This movie will hit you in the feels, it'll hit you in the head, it'll hit you in the heart, it'll hit you every fucking where. Yep, we got another classic on our hands, people, and it's called The Arrival. I'm reduced to nitpicking this movie. That's how great and awesome it was. The pacing for the movie is a little bit slow. It's kind of a slow burn type of movie. If you're going into this movie expecting an action thriller with a whole bunch of lasers and alien invasion fighting stuff, this is not that movie at all. This is a thinking man sci-fi. And if you're not a thinking man sci-fi type of person, well, then you'll probably not like this movie. For me, I liked it because it means that they took time with their story and their characters. But It is a bit slow-paced, I'm not gonna lie. There are a group of soldiers in the movie who make a decision towards the middle act that's really fucking dumb. Not even, like, a little bit dumb, like, well, they should have made a different decision. I mean, like, it's dumb, and they're soldiers, and they shouldn't be thinking like this, but they did anyway type of dumb. There aren't really any ramifications or repercussions from their actions. It just kind of happens, and it feels like extra drama thrown in. I was blown away by the arrival. I had to stay up all night thinking about this movie. I had to think about it for, like, an hour before I did this review. This movie is awesome in every single way. It was awesome on arrival, and it's prime on arrival because it's going to get the Superman Prime rating. Go see Arrival. It is one of the best films of the year. Absolutely a lock to appear in my Justice League, aka the top 10 movies of the year. If you like what you see, tell me how you feel and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Peace.